Hi everybody, I'm Jack. This is Raw Tropical Living. Thanks for joining me today. Well, I'm just easing into this Sunday. I had a time change here, making the day go slow. It's about 9:30 and it seems like it should already be afternoon, but that's okay. Just means the days are gonna get a little shorter now, or actually the sun's gonna go down a little bit quicker. Another beautiful day. I wish our little cool spell would come back, but that'll probably happen next week. So I wanted to start the week off talking about the raw food diet and intermittent fasting. Just giving my thoughts on the subject. Just my thoughts. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, I do videos every day. So I'd appreciate if you'd take the time and hit that subscribe button now. And then click on that little bell and check send notifications so you'll stay subscribed to the channel and you'll know when I have new videos come out, which is pretty much every day. I don't talk about this subject. I've actually just purposely ignored it, but I get people. It's one of those things you just know from time to time. You know, I'll get a couple of questions about intermittent fasting in messages on Instagram. I'll get a comment here and there. I'll have somebody write me about it. And I'm just usually like, well, I don't intermittent fast. This isn't my thing. It's not really something I'm interested in. And also let me kind of say that as a disclaimer before I get into that. Some things, if I'm just not interested in, I don't educate myself on them very much, or I kind of just get the basics of them and I'm like, nah, that just doesn't really suit me, doesn't work for me or whatever. But everybody seems to be on this. It's trending these days. Do you guys like that word, trending, a new word in our vocabulary over the last 10, 15 years? It's trending, but a lot of the trendy people will be on to some new trend here soon, because trendy people are always jumping. They're just looking at that list. What's trending right now? The next thing that comes in that people talk about enough, we'll have people off talking. They won't be talking about intermittent fasting anymore. Now, before I even did this video, I did what I normally do, and I went on Google and I went into YouTube and I searched, you know, raw food and intermittent fasting, raw vegan intermittent fasting, just intermittent fasting. I got on Google, I even added the word definition to that. There doesn't seem to be like a set standard definition of intermittent fasting, and it can be defined, interpreted, put into practice in a number of ways, I guess, depending on, you know, just your thinking, or there's just different ways of doing it. Some people consider it intermittent fasting to fast one day a week, to do it like that. Some people do it every few days. Now, what I had kind of come to see as the most common intermittent fasting talked about within our kind of little raw vegan, raw food circles was eating in a very short time period each day, and for some, just eating once a day, just loading up and eating it all in one meal of the day. But for a lot of the others, it was eating, if not eating in one meal a day, it was within a very short window. First of all, like I say, the eating one time a day isn't going to work for me. The not eating until afternoon isn't going to work for me. That just doesn't suit what I'm trying to do, doesn't suit my goals. I'm back in the gym. I eat. I've always told you guys I eat. So I got thinking, I just naturally assume, because of the way I do things, like, well, you don't intermittently fast, or you don't do intermittent fasting. But maybe I do. You guys know I'm going to have to refer to my notes every once in a while. Not so much for any facts or anything, because there's not a lot of fact in this, just my opinion. I just have to write things down, or I know I will fail to mention them. So intermittent fasting. Maybe I do intermittent fasting. I'll tell you what's natural for me. What's natural for me is a typical day. Normally I get up, I putz around on the computer a little bit in the morning, and most of the time, unless I've got something, you know, in the mid-morning and I need to get some food in me and get out the door, I would say the majority of the time, my first meal comes anywhere from 8 o'clock to 9 o'clock. These days, leaning closer to 9 o'clock. So first meal usually comes around 9 o'clock. I eat my dinner pretty early. I would say probably over a 30-day month, I eat my dinner by 5 o'clock. 25 to 27 of those days. So most of the time, if I kind of put an average out there, most of the time I'm eating, like most people are going to work, between 9 and 5. So I guess just by default, I am intermittently fasting for 16 hours a day. Now, I try to think sometimes how different that was. But then in a way, like, I don't know if that's that much difference, because I don't know that I ever went through a period where I just started eating like 6 or 7 out of the bed and then ate straight on through to like, you know, 10 or 11 whenever I go to sleep at night. I guess it varies. I always used to be a little bit more prone back in the old days, you know, when I ate on standard American diet, or even when I was eating a healthy version of a standard American diet at time, I would like that snack at night. So for me, it just doesn't work for my objectives. And I don't think that could, listen, I, you know, you guys know if you've watched this channel for very long, I'm very instinctual. I go very much by what feels naturally to me. I haven't pushed anything. That's one thing I got to tell you, over close to five and a half years on this lifestyle, I haven't pushed anything. I haven't made myself do something that didn't feel natural just because that's kind of how you're supposed to do it. My body, like my meditation practice, has been gently led. You know, I let my body lead me where it is ready to go. And that's not even remotely instinctual for me to wait until, say, noon or over in the afternoon to eat. And it's not instinctual for me at all to stop it, to only eat for 3 or 4 hours, to cram all that food in there or not cram all that food in there. And it's definitely not instinctual for me to eat one meal a day, because, you know, somebody that's active, going to the gym, working out, I'm trying to think, okay, let's say I decided I'm going to intermittent fast. I'm going to eat one meal a day. Well, I shoot for getting, you know, I'm not sure. I'm always guesstimating with my calories. So I've said before, I shoot for getting 3,000 calories a day. I'm not sure if I'm actually doing that. That's just my best guesstimation. But for sure, I eat up in the high 2,000s, you know, like my body would need to get 27. Okay, let's just go to the low end. My body would need to get 2,700 calories in that one meal. And I just can't think of any one meal without packing it with fat that I want to sit down and eat 2,700 calories in one sitting. Now, like I say, 8 hours, you know, packing everything within 8 hours and giving your body 16 hours to, you know, to process all that, that's okay. That's doable for me. So maybe I do intermittent fasting. Now, as far as the other kind of intermittent fasting that I've just right there, like I say, I'm not throwing that under the bus. I don't know enough about it because, once again, I don't tend to study, get into great detail into things that are not pertinent to me that I'm not going to do, so I don't need to do that. I will say this on intermittent fasting, just as I've said with other forms of fasting, any type of fasting, when I'm talking about fasting, don't think I'm necessarily throwing it under the bus. I'm talking from my perspective as a healthy person. I totally see the value in fasting. You can agree or not, and that's okay. I totally see the value in fasting when we're in a healing crisis, when our bodies need to heal. Because that's just nature's way. That's what nature does. If you look at animals, you know, when an animal is sick or hurt, it generally goes away, goes off by itself, just hunkers down, and it doesn't eat, and all the energy of the body is put towards healing. But as just an active, healthy person, no, I don't see it. For weight loss, yes, maybe, I'm not sure. That's kind of a neutral. I'm kind of saying that's a possibility I could see, but I don't know enough about it to even really make an informed statement saying, yes, I do see that intermittent fasting would be good for weight loss. But I do see it could possibly be good for something like that. But like I say, this stuff is just for me. I mean, when it comes to all this food stuff, you know, I talk about my meditation practice a lot. I did a guided meditation last night, which is all about letting go of the judging mind, letting go of judging yourself and letting go of judging others. So I always understand that when I do videos kind of critiquing something, talking about it or whatever, I don't judge anybody else's diet whatsoever. Their journey is their journey. And I kind of expect the same thing. If you ever see me kind of getting a little touchy or a little snarky about any certain way of doing it, and it pushes people's buttons the wrong way, It's because somebody, like, I kind of get this backed into a corner, like I'm going to pop you or something, when people come after me telling me what I should do. I don't tell anybody what they should do. I don't, there's no shoulds for me to apply to you. I have shoulds for myself, although I'm working on those. But yeah, I don't have, the only reason I will sometimes talk about these certain things in a passionate way like I do is when maybe I'm starting to get fed up, when people will tell me over and over, you should, or I need to be doing this. And you know, I hold back a lot. There's so many times when people, like, you know, kind of even they'll go into their, like, they'll get into some geeky long explanation of something, trying to explain something to me, and I bite my tongue. Some people wouldn't, but I'm just looking at the people going, I don't want any of really what you've got. I'm not seeing anything about your journey or about how you look or how you're manifesting this lifestyle that I want. So God bless you. Do it your way. I'm not telling you, no, you're wrong. Come over to doing things the way I'm doing. I'm just saying, back up, dude. I don't need what you got. I don't need what you got, but I'm happy to see that you're happy with what you're doing. So anyhow, that's just my thoughts on the thing. Like I say, I don't try to do videos from this all angry, emotional point of view. I'm definitely not one of these people that, because I don't do something, because I don't, maybe don't understand it, or maybe I disagree with it, I don't consider myself the ultimate authority on really anything in life. So it's kind of a live and let live. But people ask me about intermittent fasting, so I just thought I would give you my 2 cents worth on it. To sum it all up, if not eating for 16 hours a day and getting all your food in within 8 hours is intermittent fasting, then I intermittent fast. So there you go. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like it, please give me a thumbs up. If you would, share from every from time to time, and I will see you again tomorrow. Love you guys. Peace.